another fairly unique capability of the Chinook with our tandem rotor and thunder carry design is we can carry out running landings at a decent amount of speed on like a skid engine or a right sort of aircraft. What we're going to do is we're going to carry out another nose over, which went from 10 degrees nose up, 10 degrees nose down, with a 180 turn to line up with the runway. So the reason we would do a running landing for real, we could do either an unrestricted area one, which is what we will do today, which is a fairly high speed one, or a restricted one to get into a nice tight area. The reason we do it is, for instance, we lost an engine for whatever reason. It would reduce the torque burden on the remaining engine, allowing us to carry out a safe and controlled landing at heavy weight.
So it's a kind of running landing.
Yes, exactly right. It's going to run on. They're going to touch, hopefully bang in front of us at crowd centre, at about 60 knots.
Amazing, and I just think those rear blades are so close to the ground. How did you judge?
So the limit is 20 degrees nose up.
Look at that, they're just unbelievable. He's going backwards on the ground. I know they go backwards to the air, but on the ground as well.
So as they keep coming back, they're going to perform a backwards takeoff and swing out the front and form above and end with their move that I'll talk about at the end. So the dead most of it is to show the final maneuver does have operational context using over shoulder departure. Ladies and gentlemen, as they bounce you now, turn the lights off, give a big cheer, big wave for the 2015 Royal Air Force General Sway Team.